Friends, welcome back. So here we are going to discuss about the Gordon's model, that is the second relevance theory of dividend decisions. So in the last video we have seen the Walter's model, that is the first theory of relevance theory of dividends, and the second one is Gordon's model. The formula used for calculation of price per share using Gordon's model is P naught is equals to E1 into 1 minus B divided by KE minus B into R, where P naught stands for price per share, E1 stands for earning per share, B stands for the retention ratio. Means in the problem they will go for providing the dividend payout ratio. Apart from that payout ratio, whatever the remaining amount will be having, that is considered as the B, that is retention ratio. Combinedly 1 minus B will be considered as the dividend payout ratio. And KE is cost of capital and R is the internal rate of return. So if in the problem if they are not given rate of return and retention ratio separately, then they will go for giving the growth rate, which will be considered as the G. Instead of BR, we can consider the growth rate for calculation of the price per share. Let's go for explaining the Gordon's model by using the formula. So here in the question, assuming that the cost of equity is 15%, so KE is 15%, the cost of equity, and the rate of return is 12, R value is also given, that is 12%. Earning per share is rupees 20, that is E value is also given. Now they are asking you to calculate the price per share using Gordon's model if the dividend payout ratio is 15%. So this is what the question. They have given the required information for you and they are asking you to calculate the price per share by using the Gordon's model of dividend decisions. So this is what the formula we use under the Gordon's model to find out the price per share. So E1 is given, earnings per share. 1 minus B is nothing but the dividend payout ratio. Here B, how the B is stands for the retention ratio. Retention ratio is nothing but so whatever the total profit we are getting, that will be considered as 100%. That 100% minus whatever the dividend payout ratio they have given, this dividend payout ratio will be deducted from the 100%, that is 15%. 100 minus 15 you will get 85%, that is 0.85. like that you will go for calculating the B value, that is retention value. So we are having all the values, substitute in the formula. So E1 value is 20 rupees into 1 minus B, that is retention ratio is 0.15, divided by KE, cost of capital is 15%, that is 0.15 minus B into R, B is retention ratio 0.85, into R value is rate of return, that is 0.12. So now values, 20 into 0.15 you will get as the 3, and now 0.15 minus 0.85 into 0.12 you will get 0.102. So now 3 divided by 0.15 minus 0.102 will get answer as the 0.048. So now 3 divided by 0.048 will get answer as the 62.5. So this is the price per share. So this is how we'll go for calculating the Gordon's model, price per share, by using the Gordon's model. So let us go for explaining Gordon's model by using one more example. So here XY Limited achieved an EPS of rupees 20 for the year 2005 and 6. Its cost of equity was 15 and the rate of return was 18%. The dividend payout ratio was 20%. So calculate the market price of the share using Gordon's model. Again they are asking what will be the share price if the payout ratio was increased to 50%. Means here we have to calculate the price of the share two times, because they are given here dividend payout ratio is 20%, and again they are asking what will be the share price if the payout ratio was increased to 50%. So we have to calculate the price of the share two times using Gordon's model, at 20% dividend payout ratio and at 50% dividend payout ratio. First, this is what the formula. So first we will calculate when the dividend payout ratio is 20%. So now the formula, apply the formula. P naught is equals to E1 is nothing but EPS, earning per share, that is 20 rupees into 1 minus b is nothing but the dividend payout ratio. So dividend payout ratio is 20%, 0.20, by KE, cost of equity is 15%, 0.15, minus B is retention ratio. So how we will calculate B? It means 100 minus dividend payout ratio. So whatever the dividend payout ratio we are considering, that should be deducted from the 100%. Here the dividend payout ratio is 20. So 100 minus 20, you will get 80%. So the value of B is 0.80, and the rate of return they have given as 18%, 0.18. So 20 into 0.20, it will be 4 divided by 0.15 minus 0.80 into 0.18, you will get 0.144. So 4 divided by 0.15 minus 0.144, you will get 0.006. So 4 divided by 0.006, you will get answer as 666.67. So that is the value of price of the share, and the dividend payout ratio is 20%. Again here they are asking, what will be the share price if the payout ratio was increased to 50%? Let us calculate the same thing for the 50%. So now we will see what is the price of the share at the 50% dividend payout ratio. So P naught is equals to E, earning per share remains constant 20, into 1 minus B is the dividend payout ratio. So 0.50 divided by KE, cost of equity is same 0.15, minus B value again 100 minus dividend payout ratio is 50%. So B value will be 50%. So 0.50 into rate of return is 18%. So 0.18. So now 20 into 0.50 will be 10 divided by 0.15 minus 0.50 into 0.18, you'll get 0.09. So 10 divided by 0.15 minus 0.09, you'll get 0.06. So now the value of P naught is 166.67. So this is the value of share when the dividend payout ratio is 50%. This is how we'll go for calculating the price of the share by using the Gordon's model.